Are you thinking about getting in?
It is rather hot.
I dare you. How is it?
Lovely. Aren't you coming in?
I'm not sure.
Mummy, what is that?
What? I can't see anything.
Big tree.
Holy Lord. Maya, behind you. What is it?
What?
Doctor! Get the little ones up on the bank.
I'm not leaving you behind.
It's just standing there.
I think it's leaving.
I can't make it out now. It's difficult to see among the trees. It was so tall and thin. And those eyes. It could think, I know it. It was studying me.
We need to get back to town. Don't worry about the rest of your clothes. Father can send someone to collect them.
I'm soaking wet.
You're soon dry in this heat. We need to get Johnny and Lottie back. There could be more of them.
The doctor will need to know about this.
What could one man do against a creature like that?
What a charming little shelter.
Swift worked for himself well enough, but you had to lash him to get any work out of him for yourself.
Can you see any signs of intruders, Abaru?
What are you asking him for? He's just a dumb black. We only need him if we come across others like him.
Go on, Abaru.
There was a struggle. They were dragged from shelter, boss.
I can see the door has been torn off. Go on.
They were taken here and... This is bad, boss. Bad.
You can tell me.
We all in lot of trouble.
What are they, Abaru? You know what they are, don't you? Or at least your people once knew.
I suppose it was evil spirits. Black magic, eh, boy?
Keep out of this, suitor. What are they? Why do they kill, Abaru? If you don't tell me, your people will be blamed and they'll be wiped out.
They, Kimara.
How on earth? Get back, all of you.
I'll put that thing away, suitor, before you hurt yourself or start a war. Put it down, suitor, as you will only get one shot away before you are quite simply speared to death by a dozen times over.
Fine.
Huh. And now perhaps we can have a reasonable and respectful conversation?
What, pray tell, is all this about? Coming a mile away. In the name of heaven, what has got into you all?
There was some kind of thing at the waterhole. A creature of some kind.
Surely you mock me.
There was something there. I saw it. It was hideous, and it almost caught Moira. We must tell Father at once.
You must all return immediately to the house. His Excellency is waiting for you there. Now hurry!
They are going to kill us.
Yes, probably skin us, boil us alive, and then saute us with a handful of eucalyptus leaves.
You're making light of the situation?
Has it ever occurred to you to put your notions of class and race aside and just accept people as you find them?
What?
I didn't think so. Lieutenant Suter, if they had wanted to kill us, they could have done so before we even knew they were here. Now please be quiet. I'm listening.
To that mumbo-jumbo?
That mumbo-jumbo, as you put it, is a language 1,000 years older than your own. You are listening to the voices of many distant millennia. Now shush!
You are doctor?
That is my title. This is Lieutenant Suter. We came to investigate the killings here with the help of your tribesmen. I would also like to congratulate you on your grasp of English.
I also lived with white men.
Are you Penelway? Your Majesty.
Are you quite all right, Suta?
Why, this is King Willy, King of the Blacks. That's what the old governor crowned him before he ran off like the thankless savage that he is.
How very humorous for you. Now get off your knee and start behaving yourself like a good boy, please. Elder, you spoke of the Tamara?
You would not understand.
Are they the creatures from the Dreamtime?
How could you know that? You have spoke to him of these things?
I have not. This doctor knows things. He is not like other white men.
Is it something the white people have done that has caused them to return?
They are always here. They choose when they wish to be seen. They normally good to us. Have rescued our children stolen by Imjin. But they have begun to kill the white people. We know that we will be blamed.
Is there a way to contact them?
They not speak. But this night we hold Korobori, Doctor. We speak to Dreamer. We ask him why the Timara kill.
Dreamer?
That's just nonsense, Doctor. They'd believe in anything.
I have an ominous feeling that it is anything but nonsense, Lieutenant.
Swimming in a waterhole, like some peasant. I'm thankful your mother is not alive to learn of this.
Please, Father, you'll frighten the children. Up to your room, both of you.
You are just a child yourself, my dear.
But, Father, I'm not...
Your daughter tells you there's some kind of creature living in the woods behind your house, and all you're worried about is not being seen to do the right thing?
And you, young lady, I have just learned that there is no ship arriving today.
Oh.
So, you and this man who claims to be our new surgeon, how do you account for your presence here?
Well, Governor, we have our own ship. It's anchored a little further up the river.
But it must have passed the heads. It must have been seen to enter the harbor.
Unless, of course, it came from inland. Which would be impossible.
We entered the harbor at night and accidentally passed the settlement. When we realized we'd gone too far, we anchored, came ashore, and walked back.
Just the two of you? No other crew?
Well, we got dropped off in a smaller boat, just off the coast. And the doctor is a fair pilot. Listen, Governor, this creature is like nothing I've ever seen before. It was as tall as a tree. Thin, with very long arms and legs, and two round glowing eyes. I've traveled to some pretty exotic places, but I've never seen anything as weird as that.
You will answer my questions, young lady.
I have answered your questions. Now you answer mine. What are you going to do about that thing out there?
I wish they would cut that out.
Your ignorance astounds me. Can you not see any value in learning about another culture?
Culture? These people don't even know the meaning of the word. What is it they think they're doing anyway?
It's a corroboree, a tribal ceremony involving song and dance, and we're not invited. Although we can watch along the sidelines. I see Abaru has been painted up for the occasion as well. You're quite fetching, actually.
How do you know so much about them, anyway? The last surgeon didn't.
From what I've heard, your last surgeon was speared, so I think a little field knowledge doesn't go astray at times. They are conducting a ceremony in order to contact some kind of entity known as the Dreamer.
Oh, I wish them all the best.
All cultures have their beliefs about creation, young man. Even those of your own people have varied in the past. Currently, I think it's the standard belief that the world was created in 6 days.
That is the truth.
The ancient Greeks didn't think so. They believed that the world was once a giant golden egg a bird sat on before it hatched.
Rubbish.
And these people before Asuta, the ones you think of as savages, believe in a great father of all souls who created the world in conjunction with the Sun Mother.
Who are you?
A traveler. And I have seen many strange things in my time, young Lieutenant Suter. Enough to appreciate that the more you know, the more you realize you don't know. Can you hear that? I think they've made contact.
Doctor, where is the doctor?
I'm here. Are you the dreamer?
I am. And you are the doctor. You are not of this world, Doctor.
Why do the Tamara kill innocent people?
There are no innocents, aside from my children. They are to rid this place of the outsiders. You should not have interfered. Seize the doctor. My children, seize him. The doctor must die.
I told you they were animals, Doctor. This is all just black magic.
Now listen, I'm sure we can all be reasonable about this.
Forget it. They'd kill you just as soon as look at you.
Pimulue, order them to stop. You must.
We must obey Dreamer, Doctor.
Jimmy, put down that gun this instant. Captain Turner.
No, Turner! I was just making contact! Not now! Please! Pimulue, no!
There will be another time, Doctor. My servants will wipe out all outsiders from the land.
Come back here, you animal. Ah, he bit me. The blasted black animal actually bit me. If I had my gun, I...
Oh, let me see that, Suter. You'll be fine. It's just a flesh wound, though I would douse it with alcohol. I'm afraid Pimulue is dead, though.
Good.
Well, Doctor, I see you had things well under control here.
Do you know what you just did?
Yes, I just saved your life. You are wanted, Doctor, immediately. The governor himself wants to speak with you.
Oh, I see.
Right, dismount. Horses to stable, and then clean up.
Captain Turner, I see you were successful.
Suter's party were being attacked when we arrived at Swift's farm, Major.
Were there any casualties?
We killed one of them. Pimulby, King Willy himself.
I meant amongst the Marines, lad.
None, save Lieutenant Suter, sir. He was bitten by one of the natives.
Bitten?
By the governor's favorite, Jimmy.
Oh, I see. Suter, go to the hospital and get that seen to. The doctor will be over promptly.
Yes, sir.
The governor's favorite going around biting officers of his majesty. Well, we can't have that, can we?
There was something else odd about the incident, sir. As ordered, we took stock of all weapons before departure, and there was an extra gun.
Could it have belonged to the doctor?
The doctor refused to carry one, sir.
Then they must have stolen it from someone else.
I don't think so, sir. The handle has been monogrammed.
I see. I see indeed. Well done, Captain. Dismissed.
I realize you're not going to understand this, Major, but there is a lot more going on than just a simple native uprising and an opportunity to score political points against His Excellency.
His Excellency doesn't like to be kept waiting, Doctor. Off with you.
Myra! Myra, wake up!
What? What is it?
The doctor and Lieutenant Suter are back. I heard them riding in town with a squad of Marines. There's likely to be troubles. Father's ready to interrogate him. I think you'd better get up.
Right. Where are you going?
There's someone... something I must see to first.
Fair enough. Doctor, have I got a story to tell you?
Oi, steady on, Governor.
Why are you here, boy?
Boy? You're no more than a few years older than I am. I'm fair enough, Governor. I was just hiding.
From who? You were waiting for me, weren't you? Spying on me.
No, it's nothing like that, Governor.
It's that dandy Crim George, isn't it? He sent you to spy on me and Miss Emmeline.
It's nothing like that. You see, I was...
Don't bother. I know the old fella suspects. You're to go back to him and tell him that you saw nothing. You hear?
Yeah, of course.
Otherwise, I have you done for something you have no doubt already done anyway. And you'll hang.
Okay, then. Nice talking to you, Governor.
What are you waiting for?
Are you alright? You don't look well.
Of course I am. I just got a flesh wound, boy. Now go, and don't come back.
Major Knight and the Doctor, sir.
Thank you, George. Come in. I've been eager to hear your report, Major Knight.
Lieutenant Suter's party were ambushed, sir. They were lucky a squad of Marines were dispatched to collect the Doctor. And that native you're so fond of, Excellency, he was leading the attack.
That's not entirely true, Governor.
I feel that you have not been entirely truthful with me, Doctor. Where are your papers?
Sorry?
You should be carrying papers authorizing your position as Chief Surgeon of the colony. Where are they?
I'm afraid they were lost at sea. Sorry.
How inconvenient. Well, tell me then, what did happen out there past Parmata on Swift's farm?
We were taken prisoner by Pemului, and Abaru, the native you call James or Jimmy, was able to mitigate on our behalf and explain that we were merely there to investigate the killings, just as they were, not instead to slaughter their people.
They were innocent then, Doctor.
They knew that they would be blamed for the actions of the creatures who killed the settlers. They have more to fear in the short term than you do.
And so they should. We've shown them every kindness, attempted to educate and culture them, but they resist.
They have their own culture, Governor. One aspect of that culture for the Eora is a belief in the existence of a being called the Dreamer. They had been conducting a ceremony in order to contact him.
I have no interest in the beliefs of primitives, Doctor.
As they have no interest in yours, Governor, I can assure you of that. But they realize they cannot compete with the weapons you have at your disposal. They were ordered to attack.
Ordered? By whom?
Doctor!
Well, you look like you've settled in then.
I need to talk to you.
Not just now, I'm trying to explain the situation to the Governor.
But Emmeline and I saw this hideous creature in the gardens.
I see. They are certainly getting game to come that close. According to Abaru, they are normally shy but kind creatures.
You may have seen something, I don't doubt it. But it still doesn't answer my query. Who are you both?
Can't you see that who we are is immaterial, Governor? These creatures are drawing closer, and they are enormously powerful. Hang on. Why didn't it attack you, Moira?
I'm not sure. It was looking straight at me, and then it moved closer. It was as tall as a tree and very thin. But it backed off when I entered the waterhole.
Did it? Interesting.
You will give a proper account of yourself, Doctor, or whoever you are. You seemingly appear from nowhere just after two emancipists are horribly murdered. Then you claim that unless we listen to you, we will all be dead in a week.
I'm afraid it could be much sooner than that. I think I may have misjudged the situation. It's not the creatures who are the true danger. It's the intelligence directing them.
What on earth are you muttering about now? I'm going to dispatch a squad of Marines to search for your ship upriver. And if they don't find it, I'm going to clamp you in irons on suspicion of spying.
Oh, Governor, think! Don't waste time sending men to their deaths needlessly. You need to recall all the outlying settlers, post sentries right around the settlement, and give me time to develop some kind of defensive strategy. Then we could perhaps negotiate with the Dreamer.
Dreamer? What are you babbling about? If it wasn't for the word of my eldest daughter concerning these creatures, I'd have locked both of you up by now.
Recall anyone outside the limits of the main settlement, Governor, if you want them to live.
Suda, are you there?
heard you'd come back. Suta, are you there? You weren't hurt, were you?
Go away. You mustn't see me like this.
What do you mean? I've missed you. I don't care if you're dirty. Suta, you're starting to scare me now. Suta, you must be quiet. If we're caught here together, my father learns of it, you'll be sent back to England and we'll never see each other again. I think George already suspects. Suta? Suta?
The tree man, father. And he came towards us. It was black and had two glowing eyes.
Governor, the choices we make now will determine whether or not we all survive.
There are no creatures who are a danger to us except the snakes and the savages.
He ran away on his hands and legs. His skin was like a lizard's and his teeth.
Let me out of here! You must let me out! I'm the only one who can stop this!